Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, faith versus fear. Now when he had got into a boat, his disciples followed him. And when suddenly a great tempest arose on the sea, so that the boat was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. Then his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we are perishing. But he said unto them, Why are ye so fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. So the men marveled, saying, Who can this be, that even the winds and the sea obey him? Matthew 8:23-27. Did they not know who it was who got into the boat with them that day? The man who created the oceans, the currents, the winds and the waves that was in the little ship with them that day. The ship is not going down when the Creator is on board. The storm does not distress Jesus. No matter how earth-shattering, our problems do not cause our God to fear. O ye of little faith. Look what happened. They all stayed in the boat. They all continued the journey and they all reached the other side. The circumstances of the world around us should not affect our faith in God and His ability to cause us to reach the intention He has for our lives. God is never surprised by our circumstances. He wasn't surprised by the persecution of the early church. He wasn't surprised by the world wars. He wasn't surprised by the plague, the measles, the mumps, the smallpox, SARS, swine flu, or this flu. Our God hasn't lost control, and neither should we. Fear is paralyzing, causing us to do very reactionary actions. Fear creates confusion. The scripture reminds us what God has given us in the time of confusion. 2 Timothy 1:7 says, For God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Our reactionary action gives credit to the enemy. It's a trap not to follow good precautionary measures. Listen, whether we have service in a building or not, it has nothing to do with our faith in God. I like to call this thing the pandemic because it was a plan, and everything that we see around us at this point in time was truly orchestrated. However, what is the response of the church? We've seen just like Daniel and Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, while in Babylon they had to abide by what was required until what was required demanded that they give up faith in the God that they trust. Don't be fooled, saints. God is our source no matter the circumstances. He has used your job to provide for you. He can and He will use anything to take care of us in this time. Without any fault of our own, there is a new normal that is being created. However, let me encourage you with the words of Paul from Romans 8. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God and to those who are called according to His purpose. For whom He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed into the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom He did predestine, these He also called. Whom He called, these He also justified. And whom He justified, these He also glorified. What shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, For your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate me from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Saints of God, God is still in control. He has not forgotten His people. His plan for this world is still to draw the hearts of people to Him. Let us not allow this time to be a time of decrease. Let us allow it to be a time of increase. People are praying around this world like never before. Let us believe that God is going to answer their prayers, heal their land, and rescue the perishing. This too shall pass. The thought of the day: God is never surprised by our circumstances. to all my brothers and sisters who, if you must, will be going out to vote, please walk not only in faith, but with wisdom. Do all that you need to do to protect yourself. Be safe. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.